Explore more about the topics you love with Toppr. Subscribe now and keep learning.
Now we are going to learn one more use of dimensional analysis. Very, very useful use, right? To verify the correctness of a physical equation. Suppose you have given some equation, you have been given some equation, you want to check whether it is correct or not. Or in the exam, you've forgotten the equation, you're not sure this G by L or L by G, then you can check using dimensional analysis whether the equation is correct or not. Any correct equation, dimensions of left hand side and right hand side must be seen. Right? Remember that. If the equation is correct, dimensions of left hand side and dimension of right hand side has to be seen. Let us consider a simple pendulum. Right? Simple pendulum is very simple. This is one support. Here is a string. And here is a bob that is hanging from here. Right? And this bob oscillates like this. Right? And that is what is simple pendulum. Right? Physics is simple. Physics, we have got things like simple pendulum, simple harmonic motion. Right? Physics is simple. You find physics difficult, then you are not studying physics properly. Right? Or you are not being taught physics properly. Physics is simple. Remember that. So in this simple pendulum, we have got something called time period. Time period is the time to complete one full oscillation. Suppose it starts from here, it goes here, comes back here. That is called time period. Time period is the time to complete one full oscillation. Okay. And the length of the string, we take it up to center of mass of the bob. That is this length. So L is the length of the string. G is acceleration due to gravity. Right? That you know. Time period T is equal to 2 pi root over L by G. This is a very famous formula, very important formula. This gives us the time period of a simple pendulum. T equal to 2 pi root over L by G. Let us verify whether this is correct. So we look at dimension of left hand side. Dimensions of LHS. LHS, you've got only T, right? So dimension will be capital T, right? So that is the dimension of LHS. Simple, right? Physics is simple, very easy. Dimensions of right hand side. Right hand side, what all things you have got? You have got 2 pi, you have got L, you have got G, you have got square root. So this will be dimension of 2 pi, square root, dimension of L by dimension of G, right? So this is what we have to evaluate. What is the dimension of 2 pi? 2 is a constant, dimensionless constant, pi is a dimensionless constant, pi is circumference by diameter, we discussed that. So this quantity will not have any dimensions, right? So 2 pi does not have any dimensions, we did not bother about it. Now we have got L by G, square root. Dimension of L is L. G is what? Acceleration. And dimension of acceleration is? Lt minus 2, right? Velocity Lt minus 1, acceleration Lt minus 2. So Lt minus 2 here. This L and L cancel out. This will go upstairs. We'll get root over t square. Right? Because sign of power will change. So we get root over t square and that is t. And C there, C. Right? Therefore, this equation is dimensionally consistent. Dimension of left-hand side is same as dimension of right-hand side. Therefore, the equation is correct. In the exam, suppose you forget and write G by L here. Then you can check dimensionally and see which one is correct. If you're having a doubt, L by G or G by L. So just put all the dimensions for the correct equations, dimension for the correct equation, dimensions of left hand side and right hand side have to be same. But if dimensions are same, it does not mean the equation is correct. Please understand the difference. For a correct equation, dimensions of left hand side is same as dimensions of right hand side. But if the dimensions of left hand side and right hand side are same, it does not mean necessarily mean that the equation is correct. Right, I can write an equation, height of building, say height of this building, height of building equal to distance between sun and moon. Now, suppose you check dimensionally, this is L, this also is L. And you say perfect, dimensions of left hand side is same as dimensions of right hand side. Right? But is this equation correct? This is total rubbish, right? But height of building cannot be equal to height of distance between sun and moon. So even though this equation is dimensionally correct, the equation is wrong. But if equation is correct, it must be dimensionally consistent. That is, dimensions of left hand side must be same as dimensions of right hand side.
Explore more about the topics you love with Toppr. Subscribe now and keep learning.